Oliver Stone here with Town Square Media, and I'm honored today to have a conversation with a big brother to me, man, that I actually got to play at the University of Mary Hart and Baylor with. And he's, ever since his career ended at the University of Mary Hart and Baylor, he's really just taken anything he's touched by storm. And I mean, not surprised he has another huge accolade that he's in the running for. Let me introduce y'all to the one and only Mr. Javicz Jones. How you doing, sir?
I'm doing all right. How you doing, man?
Man, I'm good. All is well. All is well. So let the world know, ever since, in case you guys don't know, Javicz Jones is arguably, like I just was talking to him, one of the best football players I've ever stepped on a football field with, and had a professional career in the Indoor Football League. He started off with the Texas Revolution, I believe. Was it just one season you were with them, correct?
Yes, sir.
So he started there and, you know, took the league by storm. And the Iowa Barnstormers were where your career really broke out, correct?
Yes.
And just the kind of personality that Javicz has, you know, people just seem to draw to him. He's such a great athlete, but at the same time, he has a real humble personality. And, man, just talk to me a little bit. Obviously, first we'll get going with your time down here in the Central Texas area at UMHB. Actually, you got off to kind of a rocky start. Could you maybe tell me about when you first took a visit down here to Mary Hart and Baylor, how things got going for you?
It was interesting. It was my senior year, and it was in the spring of my senior year. And came to visit the Mary Hart and Baylor, University of Mary Hart and Baylor, and I was excited. You know, it was time to choose a college, and so it was an awesome time. And right around that same time, we had that famous UMHB dinner. What was it? Chicken fried steak?
Chicken fried steak. Yeah, with mashed potatoes.
Chicken fried steak, mashed potatoes, green beans. And man, I just couldn't hold that down later on that night. And that was something that was out of the ordinary for me, because I love to eat. And so, come to find out, when we got back home, I had to go to the emergency room, and I was in the hospital bed for about a week before they diagnosed me with Crohn's disease. It was pretty interesting, man. I had to, that hit me, and that was just, it was like, whoa, you know.
As a
young kid and trying to choose college, and you know, I didn't even remember the campus that day because I felt so sick and didn't know what was going on. But eventually we you know, went through a lot of different things to make sure that my Crohn's was manageable for the time. And then I had to swallow a pill that had camera inside of it. And this is the tricky part. As I swallowed that pill, it eventually got stuck. And so I had to go in and have surgery for that. So during this time, this was the time I was supposed to show up for training camp at the University of Mary Hart and Baylor. So it was a rough time in 2008, trying to figure out, you know, where I was going and what I was going to do. But I eventually showed up and got an opportunity to showcase my abilities, and then boom, got hurt.
Wow.
And so I had to sit out that first year. So it was a little rough time, but I knew that I was at a great program with some great coaches and obviously some great players like yourself and a lot of great guys. And so it was a great experience, and it turned out to be one of the best decisions in my life.
And I just imagine going through all of this adversity, you know, I know you couldn't wait to get your chance to get on the field, which kind of speaks for the success you've had.
That's so true. I knew deep down I had to work hard and just continue to strive and, you know, leave it in God's hands. But I knew eventually, when I got my opportunity, from all the hard work that I put in, and my mindset was hard work, that I would at least get an opportunity to showcase my abilities no matter where I was. The funny thing is, they recruited me at receiver.
Oh.
Yeah.
Not gonna lie, that's news to me.
Fact.
I didn't know that one.
They recruited me as receiver because I was an athlete in high school and I played free safety. And then eventually they moved me to safety, and then Coach Fred knows a lot about football and moved me to linebacker somewhere where I never thought I would have success. And, it was amazing.
The rest is history. I mean,
the rest is history.
Yeah,
so.
For you, I know the time when you left UMHB, you were the career holder in single season tackles and career tackles. So, I mean, Coach Fred definitely knew. He saw something.
He sure did.
And we can definitely see the rest was history with that. And, like I said, I believe your senior year, like, you know, statistics-wise, if anyone, like, if they weren't even watching games, like, I feel like just your stats would cause just for people, and I mean, understands the draw and attention that you've gotten everywhere you've gone. And then, obviously, I believe National Defensive Player of the Year that year, correct? Last senior year?
Yes, sir. I sure was. It was my junior year was pretty spectacular. So I was like, man, I remember thinking that summer, like, man, I've got to top my junior year. I got to figure out a way to do that. And it was just, I just couldn't believe how my senior year turned out. It was just amazing. And it was just, man, I obviously didn't do it alone. I had 11 other guys out there with me, 22, you know, 11 more on offense, and maybe 53 or 60, however many we had on our team. We all went to war every day, and we went to battle, man. It's up to the guys up front to keep the linemen off of me. It's up to me to make the plays, up to my defensive backs to hold down the receivers. And, you know, so it's a team effort, and I really appreciate being out there with those guys, man. It's like a lifelong brotherhood that I have being at that university. And, man, y'all guys, y'all showed me so much support, and that made me go hard every day. I never wanted to let you guys down.
Oh, yeah, man, we appreciate you. It was the same way, and that's, you know, that's how they say with your, you know, your college friends, you know, that those end up being your lifelong friends, because you look at it, college is some of the best times and some of the worst times of life, because at times, you know, you're really down to your last, you know, you scraping, you know, you using these nickels and dimes to make meals, and, you know, it gets real sometimes. So, you know, definitely being there with your brothers who you went through all that, you can't help but still have that lifelong bond with them throughout everything.
That's so true.
So, as I was saying, you know, you've had great success, UMHB, then you went to the IFL, and you really just took off once you got to the Barnstormers. Believe career tackle stats, or believe
they had me at for the league for the 3.5 years that I played. I believe they had me at, I believe it was 540.
Mm-hmm, yeah,
540 tackles for the 3.5 years that I was there, and that was pretty interesting. That was awesome news to me.
Yeah.
I just knew that I wanted to make an impact wherever I was. It started off, you know, after 2012 season. It was an awesome season, and we, throughout our years being there, we set the standard of, you know, no losses in the regular season, go undefeated, and then make it to the playoffs and slowly push our way to get to the fourth round where we got to. And I'm so glad that they've won a couple of championships since then. It was a tough situation, man. I got the opportunity to get to the Houston Texans rookie minicamp in 2013. And there was another great linebacker by the name of Darrell Freeman who was holding it down in the NFL at that time and the CFL. So I definitely wanted to get somewhere where I could showcase my abilities as well. Unfortunately, it didn't work out for me. Everybody has a different story on how they made it. So I went the arena football route and started off in 2014 with the Texas Revolution and got second team all IFL my rookie year. Playing half of the season, starting half of the season at linebacker. I had to wait my opportunity. And then 2015, first team all IFL with the Iowa Barnstormers. And then 2016 was an interesting year because that after the first game, the CFL called me to come up there. And that was pretty interesting. I decided to go do that and got released from them. So I had to come back and play the rest of the season, half of the season for the Iowa Barnstormers. And then my final year in 2017 was an amazing year. I got Defensive Player of the Year that year, and pretty cool, man. We changed the program around. So it was just, I just wanted to go and do the best I could and help out however I can.
Definitely see through the statistics. I mean, everywhere you've gone, I mean, you've made your impact. That brings us to the, you know, the big reason why we're actually having this call today. I believe the IFL has you in the running with, I believe, what, 10, 11 other guys to be one of the members of the IFL Hall of Fame, correct?
Correct. And it was news to me. It was surprising. I had no clue. And when I saw that, I was like, wow, I'm maybe a year and a half removed from the game of football. And if I've only played 3.5 seasons in IFL and I'm in the running for the Hall of Fame, that says a huge, says a lot about the impact that I had. And that's kind of what I want. I would love to have the close to my chapter in the career of football to end with being inducted into the IFL Hall of Fame. That would be awesome.
You can't beat that. And that just speaks volumes, as you were already saying, of just your impact you've made. Way to, you know, close the chapter on your IFL career then, you know, being in that elite class in the Hall of Fame.
That's so true. And it would be awesome, man. It would mean a lot to me, but not only to me, just knowing that I had, you know, these guys that I've played, you know, high school ball with and then go to college and play with you guys through the storm, through college, man, and all the hard work we put into and the dedication. It would just mean a lot because I know, you know, without y'all guys, I wouldn't have been, you know, defensive player of the year and a lot of different things in college. So it's just really cool to, I would love to just do this for all of us, you know?
Oh, yeah, definitely, definitely. If you could, please tell our listeners how they could believe you. You have a website where you can go vote for Mr. Javicz Jones to get into this Hall of Fame. Is that correct?
That's correct. You go to www.goifl.com. So it's G-O and the letters I-F-L.com. And so when you go on that website, you scroll down and there's a poll. And on that poll, there's about 10 or 11 guys, and it's asking for who to be inducted into the IFL Hall of Fame. If you can so kindly go to where you see the name Javicz Jones, it says Texas Revolution and Iowa Barnstormers, and you click on my name and click submit, and that would be, man, that would mean the world to me, seriously.
Hey, y'all, so y'all definitely go out, man. You heard the link there, goifl.com. Make sure you vote for Mr. Javicz Jones, linebacker, Texas Revolution, Iowa Barnstormer. And hey, man, I'm definitely excited for you. Definitely glad you could take a little time to have this interview with me, because like I said, you're brother to me, and you know, hearing this, I was just like, you know, we got to make sure the world hears this, and you know, you definitely deserve this honor. So definitely gonna get this interview out for you, definitely gonna share it and make sure that everyone sees the greatness that you've just continued pushing.
Man, I really appreciate that, and thank you for your time. It's always a pleasure, man. It sure is.
Oh, yeah, man. Well, hey, Javicz, take it easy, man. Wish you the best and the rest of the accolades of life. I know you got much more going on in life as well. You know, if you need a good workout, man, Javicz, go ahead and fill them in, man. I'm going to go ahead and let you plug yourself a little bit, man.
Oh, man. So far I've been training, doing the personal training aspect, and that was something, just being an athlete all the time, you know, and growing up, I just wanted to stay in the realm of maybe sports or working out, you know, because we had to work out to get better in our field of play. And so I just decided to become a trainer, and that's what I do right now. And so my business is Javicz Health and Fitness, and we're going to get that going and get that rocking. So Javicz was a nickname that I got in college, and it was pretty cool just knowing that I got guys like that to support me and go from there, man. I really appreciate that.
Oh, yeah, man. No problem. No problem, man. Well, like I said, good luck with everything. And like I said, man, y'all go out and vote. Vote for Mr. Javicz Jones to get inducted into the IFL Hall of Fame.
Thank y'all so much.